What's going on, everybody? This is an exciting day for me because I finally get to post my first ever team from VGC Scarlet and Violet Generation 9. Now, ranked is technically not out yet. The ranked ladder will be available for climbing on December 1st. However, casual battles are open, and we were able to take this team into some amazing battles and showcase some really unique abilities for some of our newer Pokemon in the Generation 9 region. So I'm going to give you guys a brief description of what this team does. The code is in the top right hand corner if you guys want to go ahead and try this team out on your own. But yeah, let me just get right into it. This is a sun team with a secondary mode. The main mode is sun, right? And this revolves around Torkoal, Fluttermane, and Scovillain. Now, the way this works, generally speaking, is Scovillain does have Chlorophyll, which means he doubles the speed in Drought. Fluttermane has Protosynthesis, which means it increases speed in Drought. Now, you'll notice that it has Protosynthesis and the Choice Scarf. Now, most Fluttermanes are running the energy that allows it to get the plus one speed boost. However, I want to be able to speed anything in the meta outside of getting boosted by Tailwind, right? So that means that my Fluttermane with Protosynthesis and Choice Scarf in Sun will outspeed pretty much every single Pokemon in the game, even with a Scarf, with the exception of maybe like a Tailwinded Mirror Match, right? That's the only thing that this Fluttermane is not outspeeding. Which is pretty amazing. Now, in Sun, Torkoal's an absolute monster. We are Terra Sun with the Choice Specs. It's very, very good. Clear Smog for Dodonzo. You'd be surprised. It comes up relatively often in this early format. We're running Eruption, Clear Smog, Heat Wave, Flamethrower. And then on our Fluttermane, we're running some coverage moves, essentially some spread move with Dazzling Gleam. But the real star of this team and the real pride and joy for this team is Scovillain. Because Scovillain has two different modes, right? I'm either going to be attacking with Chlorophyll, high speed, high damage, or I'm going to be using that Rage Powder. Rage Powder next to Torkoal is amazing. A lot of people want to set up Trick Room so that they can sweep with Torkoal. I don't necessarily need that. I can Rage Powder turn one and Eruption. There's not many things in the entire game that can take a Terra Fire Eruption in Sun. Even Fire Pokemon are nearly KO'd, if not one-hit KO, by that. And the only thing that gets around Rage Powder is Grass Pokemon. And listen, if you're a Grass Pokemon, you are not staying in front of this Torkoal, let me tell you. So Scovillain with Rage Powder flexed into Flamethrower boosted by Sun is actually quite amazing. We have Energy Ball for the Terra Grass coverage. This comes up for Dodonzo leads. And just bulky water types that you may find in the format, like Vaporeon, Terra Ground with Water Absorb. Scovillain is absolutely amazing. Now you'll notice that Scovillain also has Spicy Extract. That's for our second mode that this team operates with. Mode 1 is Sun, Mode 2 is Roaring Moon. And Roaring Moon, if you'll notice, is holding a Mirror Herb. Terra Dark, Zen Headbutt, Breaking Swipe, Throw Chop, Protect. If we're going for Roaring Moon, then that means our opponent has some prankster Pokemon that we are a little bit of afraid of, and we want to be able to out those types of things. So Roaring Moon is dark, Grimmsnarl's dark. We want to lead them together. Turn one, you could go for Swagger onto any special attacker that your opponent has. When you Swagger them, you will confuse the special attacker, and then Roaring Moon's Mirror Herb will activate, thus making Roaring Moon plus two attack, right? Because of the Swagger. It copies the benefit of Swagger, which is a really great interaction. What I like to do is Swagger, Roaring Moon, Protect. Turn 2, I can go for Scary Face into Roaring Moon, Breaking Swipe. It's a spread move. It's going to do massive damage. It's going to drop their attack. And if they're not ready for it, you can sweep very fast with Roaring Moon and Grimmsnarl. Now, he has his Protosynthesis active, which means that if I set up the Sun with Torkoal, his attack goes up another stage. So you're looking at a monster that could be like plus 3 at any moment. And also Spicy Extract also works with Mirror Herb. So there are some unique teams where you could lead Roaring Moon Torkoal, have Scovillain in the back, come out and Spicy Extract, thus activating the Mirror Herb. Really, really good stuff. The last member of our team is kind of a flex position, Baxcalibur. I just think this Pokemon's bulky. It can take a hit and it can get a KO. It's as simple as that. this thing's really good for, like, Choice Banded Dragonite. Like, yeah, Dragonite's gonna go first, but then I'm gonna kill you right afterwards, or I'm gonna hit you with a Breaking Swipe. It's Assault Vest, it's coverage moves, nothing fancy, it's bulky, it's strong. If you feel like neither of your modes has enough oomph, we just throw Baxcalibur into the mix. This team's amazing. I can't wait for you guys to see the matches. They were really, really, really fun, so I hope you guys enjoy. Thank you so much for hanging out, and enjoy the video. Yeah.
Alrighty, first match, and this is a Bombasnow with the Delibird. We got the Fast Fire Thing, E-Speed, Dragonite, Scizor, Azumarill. Alright, first game, huh? I mean, we can get Weather Control here. He can not lead a Bombasnow and kind of switch that in. I think I'm kind of down to just go for this. Because I'm not too sure what his switch-ins are, how he's gonna take certain things. In the back, what do we want here? Is this dude any good here? Probably want to bring this dude. I guess we'll bring this as well. Hail team? Yeah, hail team, let's go. Alrighty. Scary team for the first for my first ever match, huh? Alright chat, time to practice. I'm expecting to be relatively terrible, but you know, we'll play it by ear. Alright, so they lead with Azumarill and the Thingy Mabobber. Okay. Deeds of Ruin. Lowers the special defense of all Pokemon. Here's Drought. See, now here, I can honestly, I think I'm okay to just go with a Rage Powder here into Terra Eruption. They both resist fire, but like, it's kind of just okay, I think. He also might do some switch-ins. I love the Fire Fish. That fish is pretty good. The fish is pretty good. Plus, I have a feeling he wants to set up Belly Drum, maybe. I'm not too sure what he's going for here. But let's see how it goes. Welcome back, Moxie. Alright, no switch to snow. So there's that. Alright, here's the powder. I gotta turn the music back on. Oh, he missed Ruination, and then Liquidation into the Pepper. Pepper lives. Big Eruption. Nice. Okay, so at this point, I wonder if I'm faster. He could, like, Aqua Jet, though, right? No, it can't. Nice. Okay. Alright, so they get rid of the pepper, but Torkoal gets rid of both of them. That's kinda what we wanted, more or less. I actually don't know if the pepper is faster than the fish there. But it's okay. I think Rage Powder was correct in that situation. See, now here, I think I'm kind of down to just go Fluttermane here. See what they bring out here. I assume it's Dragonite, right? There's Dragonite. And here's Flutter. Okay. And let's see. Yeah, I do have a Shiny. And Scizor. Okay. Alright, so I actually think I'm just fine to Gleam here, I think. They're gonna E-Speed something. I'm trapped into this, but let's see what their plays are. They E-Speed the Torkoal. I still have pretty good health left there, honestly. Bullet Punch into Fluttermane. That one-shots? Oh, he crit me. Okay.
I kind of feel like that matters. I'm a little upset. Because that was my answer to extreme speed. Okay. I think we win, though. I can't believe it. Yeah, it's actually weird not knowing all of the speed tiers, but here we are. I mean, in a way, I distracted him. Harsh sunlight activates photosynthesis. Attack is heightened. Let's go. You love to see it. I mean, I guess there's no reason for me not to just do this, right? I don't think he can kill me with an E-speed. And he can only solo target, realistically, here. Alright, so he doesn't go for E-speed. I just outspeed and kill with Breaking Swipe. Alright, let's go! First game ever in the books. And we got ourselves our first ever win in VGC, Scarlet and Violet. Whew, the monkey is off my back, chat. I am back. Game number two. And we have the new legendary thingy. He has two of the legendary thingies. He also has a Torkoal with an NDDD, Skellerage, and Brax. So I think he's probably, it's probably Trick Room, right? With NDDD. I'm actually unsure of how exactly I want to target this matchup here. I mean, I could just go for double spread turn one. I'm actually kind of down to just go for this. Double spread turn one. Yeah, I think so. And then in the back, I'm down for Paprika. And then, I guess Dairy Queen is fine here. I actually don't know the types of those legendaries. I literally don't know what those types are. So if anybody in chat wants to let me know. I forgot to Google what the new legendaries do. Completely forgot about it. I guess we'll just do this. The bull is grass dark. All are dark as their main type. Okay. Alright. We're learning. Slug is something in dark. Okay, very helpful. So the reason I figure I should go for this double lead is, like, I feel like they could go for something like Follow Me Trick Room, and if I'm double spread, maybe I just stop it before it begins. But let's see. It's in DDD with Skullrella Reg. Moose is ground dark? Moose is ground dark. Okay. Alright, so Psychic Surge is up. I wonder... It looks like they don't even have Trick Room, really. Alright, I am kinda down to just do this legitimately. And to also do this. Right? I feel like it's fine. Let's see. It also covers for the switching of the Ice Dragon. Because the Ice Dragon has, like, a Flash Fire or whatever. I could be playing this entirely wrong, but I kind of thought they might go for a switch-in, maybe. Or I'm not sure who the Trick Roomer is going to be. Alright, that's pretty good damage. He went for Yawn onto Torkoal. Okay. I can live with that, I think. Ice Dragon will still take damage. Lovely. Alright, so when DDD dies, that's lovely. So I assume they were going for Trick Room, right? So now they don't get the Trick Room here. Who are they sending out? They sent out the bull. You guys said the bulls are grass. The bull is grass dark. I think I'm down to just let myself go to sleep, right? He's Terra typing something here. Ground dark. Oh, the moose is ground dark. The slug is... Wait, I'm reading two different things, guys. Alright, either way, it switched to ground type. So, I mean, it's still gonna take a hellified amount of damage. Earthquake. That was glitchy. This is gonna do nothing. I have a question. Does anybody know why my fairy move was not very effective versus ground? Or is this thing just that tanky? I'm asleep, right? So, yeah. I mean, I could switch out, but I don't think I want to. He's gonna kill with Earthquake anyway. I just have to get as much damage onto the Torkoal as possible, I think. Oh, yeah, I'm double scarfed in, huh? He's that tanky? That's pretty insane. Alright, so the Torkoal went for Protect. Sure. He's gonna go for Earthquake here. That's fine, I think. Because the thing is the Torkoal doesn't have any form of speed control, right? So he's gonna pick up the double knockout here. The ability lowers special attack of all Mons. Interesting. Okay, good to know, good to know, good to know. I think this is still fine, though, right? Who did we bring in it back? Oh, yeah, this is fine. How fast is that thing? Is it slow, chat? I actually don't know its stats. Is it slow? Because I have Dairy Queen here. Alright, so Paprika's attack is through the roof here. I think I'm down to go for Throat Chomp into you. And then we're gonna go Crash into you. Alright, so that was to break Eruption. Rocky Helmet. Oh my. Alright, Crash should kill here, right? Even if you're bulky. Oh, it does not! Do I lose to that then? Alright, it went for a rock throw, and this one's going for body press. Okay, I think we're fine here, right? I think we go breaking swipe. And then, I guess double breaking swipe, or do I lose to... I think I have to glaive rush the Torkoal. That should be fine. Torkoal protects. Okay. That's fine. We covered for this. We covered for this. Yeah, 45 bait speed. Yeah, I figured. Okay, I think we win here. It's a very scary when you don't know the stats of the of the opposing team. Okay. Alright, harsh sunlight faded, that's fine. Effects of photosynthesis wore off. Okay. So now we're gonna go Throat Chop and Glaive Rush. Alright, they gave up. Alright, chat, nice! We are 2-0! Let's go, baby! We denied the Trick Room by leading double spread move, which even though I didn't know anything about the bull in the back, as it turns out, chat, spread moves are broken. Alright, so my opponent is Snow. Is this the same person? It's literally the same person, right? It's the same person. But, I mean, I'm kind of down to go for the same lead, right? Like, I mean, if I lead Roaring Moon, actually, the run back, yeah. I mean, you know what they say, if it ain't broken, you know what I mean? Don't fix. I got my Delphox skin, I'm happy. Let's go. Turn off that ad. Yeah, it's legit the same person. I wonder if he leads the same thing, because now I know I live the +2 Earthquake anyway, so it's like... Why would I switch up the style, you know? took a while for that, huh? Alrighty, let's go chat. Let's see what we can do. The run back, Ochi. The run back, dude. Alright, he sends out Abomasnow and Sedatan. Alright, so here's the thing. He has Flash Fire, right? I know he has Flash Fire. But that only works on one slot. You know what I mean? So, like, I think I kind of just do this anyway. And then I just do this Rage Powder, right? Alright, so here's his Flash Fire mod. Oh, he sets out the Dunzo. What? Color me interested, chat. Double the Obama slot. He just protects. I mean, I guess. That was weird. Right? That's super weird. So what is he gonna go for now? Earthquake? We switch to Paprika, and then we, Energy Ball. What does Rage Powder do? Rage Powder forces all the moves to go to the user who used it. I mean, what's the downside of making the same play? I feel like he's gonna switch in the other fish into the Sedatan slot, so I'm gonna hit this slot. Oh, he does it. Probably switches back to Obama for speed. Oh, cool. I can't see. So he just protects and switches back to Dunzo, right? He might switch in again, yeah. But that's okay. That's okay. Looks like no switch. So this dude's just dead. Okay. I do win for Blizzard. Alright, here's the Dunzo. Alright, so I think at this point we just go for a Heat Wave and Energy Ball into the Dunzo. He's Terra-typing somebody. Hit Obama slot in case of Veil. Terra Water. Okay. Okay. Obama Snow used Earth Power. Okay, he crit me, by the way. I actually think I win there, if not for the crit. Alright, Liquidation to the Pepper. It's fine. This is in Sun. Oh, it's not fine. Did he crit me? I figured in Sun we might be pretty Gucci here. I mean, we have speed control though, so we're kind of just fine, I think. Because, like, what can he possibly switch in, really, you know? Alright, I think I'm down to go for Shadow Ball here to cover for... Because he might have Serral Edge in the back, right? We don't know what he has in the back. Shadow Ball and Breaking Swipe here. Seems sufficient. Yeah, see, we cover for the switch-in. Oh, he dodges because of Commander. Yeah, good play, good play, good play, good play. Breaking Swipe might still kill, though. Who's he targeting? I have Mirror Herb! Thanks for the boosts! That's okay! That's okay! No, I missed! Oh, never mind. Oh, he lives! No! It's okay, it's okay, it's okay, it's okay, it's okay, it's okay. Rip Bozo. Mirror Herb saved you? Yeah, definitely. Definitely saved me, Mirror Herb. 100%. I mean, that's what he gets for running the cheese, brother. The cheese. Yeah, Ghost is just faster, so now Breaking Swipe kills the other fish, too. And his only Pokemon left is Abomasnow. Woo! Yo, Mirror Herb is bussin', chat! Oh my god! Wow! Who said Mirror Herb wasn't good? Got him! Sheesh! Sheesh! Shadow Ball, it's you. I guess Throat Chop is my strongest move, technically. Boink. Bye. Bye-bye! Woo, we just 2-0'd this kid! Oh, man, he is mad! Oh, no, chat. Woo-wee! That one's going on YouTube. YouTube! Alrighty, guys, that's gonna bring this video to a close. I wanna thank you guys so much for watching the video. If you guys wanna be a part of the team building process and or a part of the live stream, follow us over on twitch.tv/brawlikjohn, twitch.tv/brawlikjohn. That's where all the fun happens. If you guys wanna give me a rental team, I'll try out your rental team and I'll make a YouTube video out of it. Follow us over on twitch.tv/brawlikjohn. Like, subscribe, sub, give me money, PayPal me, find me, give me a handshake, give me a donut, glaze, strawberry, they're all good. And more importantly, have a great day, guys. Stay brawlic. Yeah!